Learn how to share and extract data from ArcGIS Online within ArcGIS Pro. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel for another tutorial. Before you continue to watch, please take a moment to hit subscribe below if you haven't already done so. So today we continue our ArcGIS Pro series and we'll be learning how to share data to ArcGIS Online, project packages, as well as learn how to extract data from ArcGIS Online. In my last tutorial, we created layouts from scratch, so you can check that out at the top of this video right now. Anyhow, let's get into today's topic. So as I mentioned, we will be sharing and downloading in ArcGIS Pro. I have a couple tutorials already on getting started with ArcGIS Pro, so you can check out my playlist of ArcGIS Pro tutorials so far at the top of this video right now or at the end of this tutorial. So first, we will share to ArcGIS Online. We open our project with the features to be shared as a feature service to ArcGIS Online. As you know, feature services allows for enhanced capabilities in ArcGIS Online, like editing. You can share project packages, which we will in a moment. We can share map packages. Particularly in ArcGIS Online, we can share web maps and web layers, which we will also do. These are just a few things we can share. Of course, we can export our map or print it. So we will publish our web layer first. It is important that we add a service name, summary and tags. You can't publish otherwise. Also go to the configuration tab to enable feature capabilities for our layer. We need to allow editing, deleting, and the ability to sync within my feature layer. You can publish with warnings and messages, but you must fix errors. Here, I get a warning to say that my base map is not supported, so we can ignore it since it will publish anyway, or we can fix it by removing the base map. One thing I realized that's a little bit different with publishing here versus publishing from ArcMap is that ArcMap is great at providing you with the fixes for your errors or warnings, but I can't say that it's completely the same for Pro. For some errors, you really have to search for the solution. My layers are successfully published. Now I will publish a web map. We go back to the Share tab, and this time we select Web Map. The items here are pre-populated based on the fact that I already published a web layer. So as you know, you need tags and summary. You can't publish without those. For configuration, you can create a web map that's pretty much only meant for exploring. You can create a web map that can be edited, which is what we selected here. Or you can create a web map that's used for visualization only. I didn't go to the configuration tab as I don't need to configure anything else. Now that I successfully published, we can take a look at our web map in ArcGIS Online. So we go to the contents in ArcGIS Online and we see the web map along with the feature layer hosted service. In actuality, it was two things that we published. We published the web map and the feature layer. We open this newly published web map. First thing I realized is that for some reason or another, I was unable to edit. But I really didn't spend too much time investigating why, especially since I've done this before and never had that issue, so it could have just been one of those things. The feature service published with the web map, so I could always add the feature service to a new web map anyhow, with full editing control. So we will publish a map package next. Map packages can be shared online or it can be saved to your desktop, so you could always email it later. It saves any map and data referenced by your layers. We also share a project package. This one is a little bit scary. Project packages publish everything that has been done in the project so far, including maps and the data reference bias layers, as well as folder collections, toolboxes, geoprocessing history and attachments. So any tool that you've run since you started the project, it will all save in your project package. Now, we will extract data from ArcGIS Online. We go to the catalog window and go to the portal tab. Here you can search your own portal or ArcGIS Online. But the first thing to note is that I'm already signed in, as this is how I use ArcGIS Online, with my named user account, that is. You will need to sign in if you haven't already done so. So I have the option of pulling in feature services or web maps. And once I drag this information or this data into my map, all I need to do is to right click and export data, and that's it. You can always just make a simple selection from the feature service or within the web map and then export after that. Today we shared information using various methods and we downloaded data from ArcGIS Online. In my next tutorial, we explore ArcGIS Pro and its 3D capabilities. As usual, thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this tutorial with a friend or colleague who you believe would benefit from this information. Also, leave a comment down below to let me know how you like the tutorials or if you have any other tutorials that you'd like to see. Thanks again and see you next time.